Welcome to this El Nino update created November 30th, 2015. My name is Mark O'Malley with the National Weather Service in Phoenix. El Nino conditions have been present in the equatorial Pacific since last winter. However, in the past 8 months, sea surface temperatures have steadily increased. Currently, strong El Nino conditions are entrenched with temperature anomalies solidly above the 1.5 degrees Celsius strong threshold. For impacts affecting the United States, we look at sea surface temperature anomalies near the Nino 3.4 region. In these images and animations, measurements in this key Nino 3.4 region have easily eclipsed the 1.5 threshold, as shown by this purple line on the right, indicating this strong El Nino event. These equatorial anomaly measures may be peaking here in the next several weeks, though should remain above the strong threshold for much of the winter. One important aspect of seasonal forecasting is assessing El Nino strength. Weak El Nino episodes have far different and lower reaching influences than the stronger episodes. Analyzing several dynamic and statistical models yields an overwhelming agreement that strong El Nino conditions will prevail through the winter season. These strong El Nino events have historically led to the most reliable predictions of wetter than average weather across the southwest United States in the winter season. How does El Nino affect the winter weather in the southwest? Well, warmer than average water becomes established over the central and equatorial Pacific regions during the winter. This warmer water enhances thunderstorm activity more frequently south and east of Hawaii, which can disrupt the downstream atmospheric flow pattern across the United States. Conceptually, the traditional flow pattern during El Nino winters features an enhanced subtropical jet, which pulls more storm systems and moisture east from the Pacific. However, each El Nino is a little bit different, and this conceptualized flow pattern does not persist for the entire winter. There will still be drier periods in the southwest U.S., but this type of pattern may be preferred more often during this El Nino, especially during the latter parts of the winter into spring. Seasonal forecasts are given as the probability of a longer-term outcome, given the limitations of forecasting individual stretches of weather systems throughout an entire season. This is especially true in the southwest United States, where just one or two weather systems during a season can comprise a large percentage of the precipitation. Overall, there is little climate signal suggesting warmer, colder, or near-normal temperatures in the southwest this winter. However, given the strong El Nino, there is a shift towards much better chances of above-average precipitation, particularly after the new year. While that's not a guarantee, the better than 60% chance of above-average precipitation is a very good signal and leaves little chance that the southwest will end up with a dry winter. Looking at past strong El Nino winters to discern any consistent trends in precipitation across the United States, we look at the southern tier of states, and there is the definitive trend for wetter than average conditions during the winter. But every year is slightly different. While the coastal areas of Southern California may become susceptible to flooding during strong El Nino events, the desert regions of Southeast California and Arizona have historically not experienced frequent flooding during strong El Nino episodes, though flooding can happen in any season at any time. Since this winter will experience one of the strongest El Nino episodes on record since 1950, we can look at the three previous El Nino events of similar strength, 1972 and 73, 1982 and 1983, and 1997 and 98, all generally produced above average precipitation for much of Southern California and Arizona, as seen in the blue colors here. Repeating that flooding has historically been relegated to coastal California during these stronger events, localized flooding can occur at any time, so it's important to always be prepared for excessive rainfall and use caution when driving through low-lying areas during heavy rain. Another way to view the influence of the strong El Nino episodes is to look at the historical likelihood or frequency of ending up with one of the wetter or drier winters on record. Based on past history, the outcome of having a winter in the wettest third has been better than 80% throughout Southeast California and Arizona. On the other hand, strong El Ninos rarely, if ever, produce winters in the driest third for our region of the country. And remember, every El Nino is a little bit different, and this analysis is based on a limited sample size, but the trends are definitely good. Even another way to measure the influence of a strong El Nino is to look at the historical number of precipitation days through Arizona. The total number of days and the moderate and heavy precipitation days are shown here for Phoenix. The monikers of moderate and heavy are somewhat arbitrary, but are given to differentiate these categories, but not necessarily give a direct measure of intensity. Regardless, when we look at either Tucson or Flagstaff, the trends hold that strong El Niño winters historically have led to more days with precipitation. And again, although this is a limited historical sample size, there would be an increased probability of more days with precipitation, which could be an impact for construction or landscaping, recreation, etc. across the state. We've talked about how the odds are tilted towards wetter than normal conditions this winter, but that doesn't address snow versus rain. Obviously, it must be cold enough when a weather system passes through to support accumulating snowfalls. But a look at the three strongest El Niño cases, the snowfall for a few select locations in northern Arizona have historically shown the mountains have done well with respect to snow totals. For example, in Flagstaff, 1972 and 73 was more of an anomaly and a benchmark for excessive snowfall, but even the other two strongest El Niño years produce good snowfall. Again, this is a small sample size, but here for Pine Top, we see very similar results. And if the odds say that the best chance for greater than average precipitation and more precipitation days is in the longer run, the odds are tilted to favor better chances for above average snowfall in the northern part of the state. So in summary, strong El Niño conditions are well established over the Pacific, and the atmospheric pattern has responded. This strong El Niño will persist through the winter and gradually weakening during the spring and summer of 2016. As a result, the odds are tilted towards a wetter than average conditions this winter in the southwest, and especially towards the second half of the winter. A look at past strong El Niño's events supports the idea of wetter than average winter, though it's really difficult to make much more of a definitive statement on how much wetter or any flood potential over the inland desert locations. Thank you for viewing this multimedia presentation. You can also find us on the web, Facebook, and Twitter at the addresses listed here.